What's going on, guys? I'm Speedy Morman, and on behalf of Netflix, this is a Jeen-yuhs talk. I'm joined by someone who certainly fits that bill. He's an icon, a mogul, and maybe the best Twitter philosopher in the history of the internet. Biggs is in the building. Biggs, what's up, man? How are you?
What's going on, fam?
Jeen-yuhs. It is the three-part documentary series about Kanye West. It kind of documents his entire life from the beginning of the journey through the Roc-A-Fella era and now into superstardom and his Jeen-yuhs era. And so let's just take it back to the beginning. What can you tell me about meeting Kanye West for the first time? What do you remember about a young Ye from Chicago?
Hungry, talented, comedic.
No, I had an accident. I almost died and everything, right? So I used to be sitting up in the hospital bed for the first 7 days. And I'll just be watching TV, man. I just came to some revelation. People were like, yo, you almost died. What came from this? And I just sit back and just decided that I'm gonna be the best dressed rapper in the game. Because I was watching the niggas gears like crazy whack, man.
His thirst to get on was like unmatched. You know, even for the people that we had down with us, you know, we had a lot of talent with us, but not the hunger that he had.
Yeah.
Put it this way, he would play a beat for Jay and then start rapping to, you know what I mean, his own verses. Yeah. He was like, look, you're gonna take this beat with me, without me, or whatever it is, and nobody else would do anything like that or even have the balls to do something like that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, did you hear that? Close mouth don't get fat. You wouldn't have said nothing, you wouldn't have been on that.
Just a long ass way from fucking rapping in my mama's crib.
As a viewer of it, I'm watching the young Jeen-yuhs at this time walk around the office trying to get people to listen, trying to get people to believe. And as Cody said in the voiceover,
the first time I heard Kanye's music, I thought it would win Grammys. But Roc-A-Fella just wouldn't take him seriously as a rapper.
I did.
Did you?
Hell yeah. The talent was something. And the sound, sonically, he had brought something that we haven't heard at that time, even to the point that Dame didn't believe in it. Mm. You know, so Dame was like, look, let's just make this first project a mixtape and put everybody on it. And I was like, this project is too special. The talent is too special. So I fought for that, you know, so he can have that solo album so it can be a full Kanye project.
What was it that made you take it serious?
I mean, with Ye, you're gonna definitely get the energy. Sometimes, you know, Kanye, he gonna play a song and he don't care if you're on the phone or what's happening. Yeah, he gonna be right there rapping in your face till you put that phone down. And literally, he would jump on a console, jump on a table, you know what I'm saying? And rap every lyric to whatever it is that was playing. I mean, Kanye would play it as many times as you let him, you know? He made sure that his presence was felt, the song was felt, the production was felt, and you left there knowing who Kanye was.
Being in the Roc office at that time, I imagine some surprising things happened, some weird things happened. Mm-hmm. What comes to mind as a memory from that time?
I mean, look, you got, you know, some people in the office, our open office, they there bagging up weed. You got, you know, some A&Rs listening to music next door. Then you got people on the side smoking weed in the back and you know, I mean, it was nobody complaining. It was just all love and it was like a family atmosphere. You know, everybody from different neighborhoods, streets or whatever, but I guess because we were all alike and coming from that same community, we can relate.
You had a team of Jeen-yuhs that kind of helped breed this company that we now know as Roc-A-Fella. So how important would you say it is to have fellow Jeen-yuhs or fellow future Jeen-yuhs around you?
Very important, you know, because it was iron sharpens iron. You know, like Jay said, and feeling it, everyone was each other's crutches. Mm. So nobody could fall off, but we also applied that to everything, you know. So we were all each other's strength, you know. So it eliminated a lot of weaknesses that we had, you know what I mean, because we came together as a unit.
For you, Biggs, how is it that you are able to kind of see Jeen-yuhs in someone?
That's a good question, and it's funny because a lot of people tell me that, but I don't know if it's my superpower, maybe that's my Jeen-yuhs, but I am able to see things in people that they might not necessarily see in themselves. And, you know, and I could see some talent that's gonna last a long time, obviously in building that, you know, in the company with the artists that we did.
Why do you have that capability? What gives you that Jeen-yuhs?
I didn't want to lose. You know what I'm saying? So when I see something and I believe in it, I'm gonna go all, you know, I'm gonna go as hard as I can for it. Mm. So I remember when when he got into the accident, Dame was like, yo, we gotta give him some money to buy MPC so he can make some beats. So I think me and Dame put up like $10,000 a piece, not even out of Roc-A-Fella money, our personal money, to give him a beat machine. And then that's when we did Through the Wire.
So you believe so much that you dig it in the personal pocket?
100%, yeah.
Is that a testament to like what you're willing to bet to win if you really believe in something?
That's a testament to it, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Is there a limit to that?
Nah, there's no limit if I believe, because I know I'm gonna get it back. And that's how I look at whatever it is I'm building. You know, if it's one of those things that I can't take my mind off of, then I know it's something that I'm gonna be attached to and I'm gonna give my all to. So even like now, starting over, you know, there's only two artists, right? There's Mez and St. John, right? And these are the only two people that I gravitated toward because the multi-hyphenate individuals that has talent that I believe is gonna be the next biggest brands going forward.
What does genius mean to you?
It's I'm sitting there listening to something that's amazing, and then he's talking about three projects ahead.
Yeah.
Names, singles, and had everything laid out.
Yeah.
That's genius.
Man, what you need to understand is when I do this album, it's gonna be the realest shit you ever heard.
He's not just talking about it, he's proving it at every single point. So you're able to see the genius. It's not like somebody's just like, oh, this is what I am, and you don't see any results after that. You see the results from Kanye, and I thought he was a genius early on. You know, like I said, the comedian comes out, the lyricist comes out, and the song-making ability comes out. And you didn't really have a lot of people with that trifecta at that time. I knew that he was gonna be one of the biggest artists of all time. And not only that, as we got to know him, we knew it was gonna be the biggest brand of all time.
Hold on. The Bling Ching.
What are some of those things that you once heard Kanye say that he has now brought into fruition?
I'm gonna be the best. I'm gonna win Grammys. People are gonna recognize me. They're gonna know my name. You know, it's like the question is, what didn't he say
that he brought into fruition?
That's my thing, willing to beat the negative perception that they try to throw on a confident black man because they haven't seen that before. I'm gonna tell you how I feel about me. I am the greatest. And you should feel that way about yourself too.
Kanye is so special. It's not like he's one of the best artists of all time in history of music. You know what I'm saying? So to think about what we did in a short amount of time, relatively speaking, to how long music has been around or even hip hop, you know, 1996, which is what, 26 years, and Kanye came in probably 7 years after that. Mm-hmm. You know, to have that time and to win the accolades that you have, not only that, in fashion, in film, the way he sees things visually, on every level, it has to be perfection. It's just crazy to see where we at right now, the impact that they're having. You know, not even only on music, now it's on culture.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So The Rock has moved culture into a place where it's about building brands, authenticity, and doing it on the biggest levels, period. Mm. And letting them go. A lot of people don't want to do that.
Right.
They want to hold on to that forever. I was proud to be able to let him go and for him to do his own thing with everybody else.
Yeah.
So it was about building artists to a point to say, this is how you can do it on your own. And no one else was doing that. We was giving those gems.
The documentary is a finite amount of time. You can't have everything in it. I'm wondering just you, through your eyes, what's been, or what is your favorite memory on this journey of Kanye?
Introducing him to Europe, because he didn't want to go. You know,
Kanye didn't want to go to Europe?
He did not want to go to Europe.
Why not?
Like literally, we had to go get him and force him in the car to put him on a plane. And I remember a few years ago, Virgil, God bless, the year before, we was actually at a Louis Vuitton party before he got that gig. And he was like, yo, thank you for bringing Ye to Europe because that opened it up for all of us. We had this party at the house, and I remember him and Mos Def was going back and forth, you know what I'm saying, in a rap battle. Kind of, you know what I mean? They were just spitting, but you know how it is. They, both of them so competitive. He fell in love with Europe, and that actually opened up everything for him fashion-wise,
right,
which actually built him more of a brand and made the music, you know, more expansive. So that right there is one of my one of the great memories because he fought tooth and nail, against that.
Wow, appreciate you, man. I've soaked up so much game that I'm definitely taking with me for the rest of my life. And thank you, not only for sitting with us, but for your journey and for impacting this generation and for helping create and cultivate one of the greatest geniuses we've ever seen in Kanye West. So
it's a pleasure. And again, thank God. It's funny, I was listening to the project too, and I forgot all about this shit, but
what you think?
Even how he started, I got something for the kids. Drug dealing, just, you know what I'm saying? Like, you'd be like, you know what I mean?
4, 5, 6.
Do I like this? I think so, as he said, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, it evokes emotion, everything he does. Yeah. I'm just saying he does that better than anybody. You know what I mean? I call him like the Dave Chappelle of rap.